Well, earlier this year was their first win over the Magpies on any ground since 1976. And that match, of course, being remembered for the famous Graham Allen kick. In this day and age, too, when totals and winning margins resemble cricket scores, the last three games between the two sides have been won or lost by 9 points or less. Could the Bulldogs make the five? We pick up play now at the seven-minute mark of the third quarter, the Magpies leading by 11 points.
And, in fact, over the line on the floor. So, again, the Dogs. The opportunity. To the half-forward line, Cloak playing in front of Edmund. Plays on now. Phillips, has he got the pace? Just gets his kick in time. Egan and Shaw battling. Back to the middle. Raines taps it over the top for Shaw. That was Gary. Pushed wide, however. And the chance for McLean. He goes short. Finding Brian Royal. Hasn't been as prolific a kick winner as we know him today, but he finds Beasley here. Tucked right on the boundary line. Plays on with a pass. Oh, here's danger because Wallace could go into the open goal. Steadies. Fires at goal and puts it through. So Wallace kicks his first goal and the Dogs come back.
It's a nice piece of play there. Good play by Beasley. A short kick. Sevens big league shows the replay of Royal putting the kick high. Beasley taking the chest mark. And he was very quick to see Wallace on his own. The short pass coming across the ground. There it is. Through the centre by Steve Wallace. So once again, 5 points to margin. Cloak and Purser. Neither ruckman have changed throughout this game so far. Bounce favours Cloak. Runs past Raines and Toomey. Turner's there for Collingwood. His kick into the centre, and it's taken by Neville Shaw. The hand pass wide to Raines. Raines gives it on to Mullane. Coming up towards half forward. Mullane's kick off the side of the boot, but it could be effective. Richardson took his eyes off the ball. Hand pass over the top from McMullen to Williams, and it's a goal!
Well played by young McMullen. He thought about having a go. Then saw his skimmer in the square. 7-11, plays 5-12. Three goals to Collingwood's Mark Williams.
On replay, he watches Jeff Raines. It's the hand pass to Mullane. The kick coming forward. Richardson all on his own. Ducked ahead. And we find McMullen put the hand pass over the top. And the goal to Williams.
7-11, plays 5-12. Collingwood leading by 11 points, but unable to break away to a handy lead. Still, the Dogs hang in. Raines could have tackled too high, but no, the umpire says play on. Pushed out wide towards McLean. He runs into trouble, dropped it. Toomey comes away with strength. Sweeps out a handball wide towards the wing. Foster is there, but hassled by Banks. And hassled illegally, said the umpire. So Peter Foster onto the left foot into the half forward zone. No mark taken. McPherson got up high, fisted down towards Cloak. He's got backup support. McKeon gives it out towards Raines. He twists and turns and weaves his way out of bother and then goes via the members stand to try and go towards goal. Out of bounds and a throw in to take place at the centre wing. 11 points the margin. Of course, we all remember the last time these two met. Let's see the last kick of the day. Brian Royal. Boy, can he keep it in? The wind is drifting it over, I'm afraid, on the floor.
Once again, good play by Ricky Barron. Sandy, he virtually forced that kick out.
Taylor to centre wing, a torpedo punt. Kellett, his name all over that one. Again, looking for Edwards, finding him this time. Plays on to Royal. The Dogs wanting a goal. And Brian, you haven't got the kicking boot on today. Because again, he pulls it this time with the left foot out of bounds in the right forward pocket.
He did swing that one. He had the lead coming from Sewell. Tried to find him, but swung it too wide. Over the back it comes. Neville Shaw does well. Lovely pass from Neville Shaw. Finds Raines. And Raines right in the centre of the ground. Should go long and direct. Brings it wide. Richardson there. A well-placed kick. Richardson plays on. Swings it back towards the goal. A well-placed kick from Richardson. And a good mark. Collingwood's given Mark Williams a well-placed kick as we watch the replay. Lovely kick from Richardson and a good mark by Williams. Three goals so far to Mark Williams. Dangerous forward. Hit the post. So it's three goals too to Mark Williams, and it's Collingwood 7-12, Footscray 5-12. So exactly two goals the margin. Short pass from fullback Egan, the player to take the mark, still in the back pocket. Now the kick from Egan. Well, when you find they kick straight to the opposition, then the first kick was a waste, wasn't it?
Yeah, total.
Grains, after taking it from Cloak, puts a long kick down the ground, and after that, well, it's a mark to Morwood.
He's stolen. Look at this.
We'll watch again on replay.
Either that or he's got elastic hands.
I think he did steal it, but it's a mark nonetheless. He's directly in front, 30 metres out.
Good on him. Let's see what he does. The drop punt. Oh, he's swung it. But no, he's got it through. But now the Woods have opened up their biggest margin today. 8-12 plays 5-12 on 7's big lead.
Yes, and we watch on replay as Egan's kick goes straight to Cloak. The hand pass from Cloak across to Raines. And the value of a long kick. Jeff Raines, a beautiful kick. Morwood coming from behind.
He might have just about got that.
Well, he finished with it anyway.
Whether he started with it, we'll never know. Here's the bounce once again. Now, what can the Dogs do? Cloak beaten for it on that occasion. They'll certainly run out their determination, but they've got to get the score on the board. McLean receives from Purser down to the half-forward line once again. Push towards the line, and can Bamford keep it in? He does so too. Pushes it back towards the forward pocket zone, only to see a strong mark taken by Greg Phillips. Greg's another one that always likes to see the handball moving, but no, he goes for the kick this time because Gary Shaw is loose just on the defensive side of centre wing.
No 15 metres because he was going to play on, does so now. Gary Shaw towards centre half forward. Oh, good mark.
Down to the square, goes got Morwood and Williams, Bobby.
Lovely kick from Raines, right to the square. No mark taken. Kennedy forces the ball through. 1 point to Collingwood. And so it's 3-1, the margin, 8-13 to 5-12.
Kennedy again to bring it back into play. The Dogs must do something. Season 84 is just about leaving them behind if they're not careful. Brian Wall at the back of the pack goes back towards the centre wing area. Jimmy Edmund got a nice old shove, and he'll take the free kick. David Toomey, not impressed. So Edmund from the wing to put Footscray into attack. Oh, Beasley's come out a mile. And Edmund's kick slightly off course. Sewell could have given away the free kick. And it will be Taylor again to receive. Oh, out come the runners. Beasley's in trouble. Behind play, Beasley is in awful strife. There are runners everywhere and medicos as Hawkins goes down towards Sewell in the pocket. Beasley's not moving on the ground at the moment. There he is. We'll stay with the action until they pull it up. Still the opportunity for McPherson. Onto the left foot he goes. A long kick in towards full forward. And a good mark taken, I think, by Edwards. So Butch Edwards. And while all this is unfolding, we'll see the mark again in replay. He's kicked one goal today. But being carried from the ground is Simon Beasley. Well, should Footscray go on and record a win here, it's going to be even worse news than they finish the season today. Most unfortunate.
Another kick, I think, Sandy.
Yep.
It'll be a 15-metre penalty right up the line. He'll go.
Watching Beasley leave, and poor old Robert Groenewegen limping onto the ground with a bandaged left foot, left knee. So they've just about hit the bottom of the barrel as far as replacements are concerned. They can't dig too deep, only got two on the bench.
...14 points the difference, and we pick up play in the third quarter at the 21-minute mark.
Foster and Banks doing all the leading. McLean waits behind. gets shoveled off it, then tunnel balls it out the back door. Richardson just paddles along in front, twists and turns his way out of trouble, gets it onto the left foot, up towards the half forward line. Gary Shaw waits down. Here's the chance now as the speedster fires towards goal. Great kick on the run, he's put it through. Gary Shaw opens up the margin. 9-14 playing 6-12 on 7th big lead.
A nice goal by Gary Shaw, and we watch on replay. Mike Richardson, right, left, and the talent of Richardson showing out as he puts the ball forward. Gary Shaw straightening up, and a lovely goal from Gary Shaw.
Special comments from Triple Brownlow medalist Bob Skelton.
Cloak and Purser. Purser gets the tap down, taken by Edmund. Almost a one-hander by Phillips. Recovers well. A hand pass towards Barr, and he was under a lot of pressure. Barr lost it, but able to tap it out. Again, Collingwood loses as Bamblett picks the ball up, puts it wide to Hawkins. Hawkins from the half-forward flank, hooks it back. Edwards can't take the mark. Tap down, McPherson coming through. Pack forming. Edwards is there, so too Taylor of Collingwood. And Glenn James saying, give it to me. I'll bounce it about 30 metres out from the Footscray goal.
22 and a half minutes gone. Bob, third term.
Big pack of players around this bounce. Cloak grabs it. The hand pass wide. Tony Shaw racing after it. Can he get there before the boundary? No. And so a throw-in to take place midway between forward pocket and half-forward flank for Footscray. Groenewagen in the front position. Cloak using his body well. Groenewagen gets the tap down. Picked up by Duperuzel. His kick up towards Edwards. Punched away by McCormack. Toomey coming on the scene. Punched it forward. He runs over the boundary line. So the throw-in this time in the forward pocket. 68 to 48. 20 points the margin. 23 and a half minutes almost as it's grabbed by McPherson.
Too
He's
high.
Tackled. Too high, says umpire Glenn James. The tackle. He did grab him over the shoulder as Sandy Roberts called. And McPherson with the opportunity of kicking his second goal and making the margin 14 points. Quite an acute angle though, Sandy.
Yes.
They're not easy to kick from there because at this stage there's quite a bit of pressure. Steve McPherson. Plays on now. Hooks it towards goal. It's a nice goal to Steve McPherson, his second.
In this third term, and it's all set up for the final quarter once again, and could it be the last quarter of football for Footscray this year? Who knows? Here's the centre bounce with Royal scooting out. They only want another one this term. They're back in business. Up towards Edwards, can't take it. Bamblett was waiting down. Oh, McCormack tried to go through strongly, went without it. Taylor tried to punch it out. Here's danger because Edwards receives from Groenewagen. Steadies onto the left foot, but he's hooked it and pulled it out of bounds on the fall. Duperuzel is off. They're making a couple of changes. Well, Beasley wasn't badly hurt. He's back on again. Anderson is off the ground with Duper, and McKenna and Beasley are on.
Beasley must have just been shaken up, Sandy, I think.
That's good that he's quite okay.
So it's Turner of Collingwood. Kick off the side of the boot. Reigns in the front position. Couldn't quite take the mark. Mullane's held. We're not in possession of the ball.
Free kick push, said the umpire.
And he'll take it. Plays on immediately. Tony Shaw's there. Shaw and Hawkins. Neither player could take the mark. Lending support is Toomey. Toomey's kick off the side of the boot, out towards centre wing. Foster leads in the race for leading support this time as Footscray's Hawkins. His kick wobbles forward. Tapped on that time by Callett, but it runs over the boundary line. So a throw in midway between centre wing and half forward flank for Footscray, out of sight of the ground. Almost 26 minutes have gone in the third term, and it's 14 points to margin in favour of Collingwood. Phillips high over the top, but he's hit it the wrong way. Toomey grabs it, taps it out, picked up by Turner. Turner's kick drops short and Raines takes the mark, breaks the tackle, puts a nice kick over half forward. Morwood's there, couldn't take the mark from behind, couldn't do so. Egan gets the hand pass to Callett. Callett now puts a long kick out wide. Cloak in position, couldn't quite take the mark. Neville Shaw coming through, but Cloak was being held, and he will take the free kick. Really come into it in this third term, Sandy.
Yes, certainly lifted himself, gets it across to Turner. He tumbles a punt up towards Banks, can't get there in time. Tackle too high. Yes, says Glenn James. And so the free kick will go the way of Footscray's Darren Baxter. To centre wing. McPherson tried to use the body. Sockers it forward. Now the opportunity for Sewell. Royal. Out comes Beasley. One, two, and he's got it. Well, he hasn't goaled to date. I'm afraid the cupboard has been bare for Simon thus far. But, well, this is the one he wants to try and break that 14-point leeway that Collingwood have held for the bulk of this term. They shot away to 20 points on a couple of occasions. But Footscray have picked them back. Can't get under this. Now, what can he do? Oh, it's a good-looking kick. It's a goal. Back come the Dogs. 8 points the difference on Seven's big lead.
It's a nice goal. If you watch on replay, Sewell, now in defence. Taken by Royal. Plays on. A well-placed kick from Royal. Sees the lead from Beasley.
Plays 8-12, 8 points the margin. Well into time on, almost by 3 minutes. Neville Shaw's handball goes astray. Now the opportunity for McKenna. No, Neville Nash has pulled it up and said holding the ball. And so it will go back to Neville Shaw. Gets his kick up towards the half forward line. Time running out for Collingwood. They want a steadier, and Jim Sewell takes a good mark in front of Ballwood. He's certainly done his bit. His kick back towards the half. Barham sets himself on that half back line. Now he'll fire in towards the forwards again. Glenn James says, go on, get your kick and play on. He does so. Williams will be the flyer. Can't complete the mark. Who's waiting down? No one able to take it away as Williams scoots out. Neville Nash says, gentlemen, let's have a bounce. And there was 10 or 12 of them in a pack there. So here's the bounce. 25 metres out from the Collingwood scoring zone. Won by Purser, but tapped to Tony Shaw. Down towards Morwood. Who's he got running for him? Richardson. Tap it again, they say, but he can't do so. And eventually it is taken through for one by.
Foster was the player who made sure that went through. And it's 9 points the margin in favour of Collingwood. As Sewell puts it wide. Gary Shaw in the front position. Good mark to Gary Shaw. The value of being in front. Hawkins saying, I brought the ball down, but Gary Shaw stood his ground well. Goes to the short pass and finds Banks, who almost lost his head. It didn't quite connect.
She'll be on in the last quarter, Bobby. It'll be like a grand final in the last quarter, don't worry, with Footscray having to come from behind. Whether they're good enough, we'll have to wait and see. We're in the fast approaching the 30th minute of this quarter. There's the kick from Banks, long in towards full forward, and I think he's got it. He has. So again, they open up that 14 or 15 point break. 15 points, in fact. 8-12 to 10-15 on Seven's big lead.
Yes, on replay. You see the value of being in front. Doug Hawkins saying that I touched it first, but Gary Shaw was in the front position. And the rest is history. It's one goal, is it? Nice little pass to Banks, and Banks finished it off with a goal from the centre bounce. 15 points to the margin. Wallace takes possession. Not a long kick from Wallace, straight to the opposition, and Taylor will bring it wide out towards centre wing. Banks coming across, punched away by Foster, taken by McLean. The hand pass out to Royal. Royal now. Kick dropping short again. Bambler taps it away. Bambler still there. Does well. A good turn of speed. A nice hand pass to Edmund. Chance of a score coming up as Garwood goes. Jimmy Edmund. It's a lovely goal.
Yeah, back come the Dogs with a quick reply. And still they hang on in there. A 9 point break now to Collingwood.
In the final quarter, we're at the 9 minute mark and it's Collingwood leading by 9 points.
At the end of which Footscray are kicking as if it's 10-7 at the other end. Banks puts it up, Andrews,
got it! Back to Andrews, a lovely mark! He has it, so
Ronnie shows a great mark to Ron Andrews.
Careful, Ronnie, those hamstrings. He's stretching. I think he might have done something. But listen to the crowd. They love him. Oh, he's a great man. The drop punt on its way.
And we move the clock forward now to the 15 and a half minute mark, same term.
Over centre wing, Cloak is the target. Didn't try and mark it, tried to tap it forward. Waiting down his reins, he goes steaming in towards full forward. Ronnie!
Ho-ho! Richardson calling for it in the square. But I agree with what Andrew is doing. He should just steady and straighten up and kick it to direct. Now again, as Mark Williams saying, just kick it over my head.
See what he does. One of the favourite sons of Collingwood, even though he's only been here a short time. He's gold, and one could almost say, good night, Footscray, for season 84. But football is a funny game.
Yes, well, Footscray, right throughout this game, Sandy, have looked as though they're going to be run over by Collingwood as Rains on replay. Seven's big league. And it's Ronnie Andrews. Bad defence that time from Alan Edwards. Gave Andrews far too much start. And it's two goals in this term to Ronnie Andrews coming on in place of Shane Morwood. 20 points the margin. Centre bounce. Richardson coming through. A nice hand pass. Missed that time by Phillips. Picked up by Toomey. Toomey's kick towards half forward. Touched off the boot, so it's play on. Andrews once again. Traps it, gives a hand pass wide. Mullane's a player. Mullane, can he score from here? He hooks it back. It looks a great goal! Oh. Darren Mullane, a beautiful goal!
And Ronnie Andrews flickering in the last three, using his strength, getting the handball out. And look at the Collingwood players. And there's one of the great goals from this game, kicked by Darren Mullane. Here it is with Andrews again. Look at the handball, Bob.
Long hand pass. Mullane. Snaps truly. Lovely goal from Darren Mullane. And so 26 points the margin. That's the greatest margin held by either side at any stage through this game.
That's certainly the wrong stage of the game that Footscray would like to see that lead stretched. What can they do? From the centre bounce, Cloak wins it, taken by Tony Shaw to the half forward line. Tap back towards the middle. Turner can't pick it up for Collingwood cleanly. And so another bounce. Well, they've tried valiantly, the Dogs, but I think it could be over for them. It's asking a lot to make up this leeway now and in fact hit the front. But it's been done. Royals kick out wide towards the flank and over the line it goes for another throw in with Ron McKeon just seeing it over the line. Footscray players not moving with that same sense of urgency as they were 5 or 6 minutes ago, because one Ronnie Andrews has put a decent old dent in their aspirations for the finals. Just picking it up and keeping it in play for Collingwood was McMullen down towards the half forward line once again. Mullane the opportunity, the running Richardson receives. This could be another one out in front of Banks. If it sits, he's in business, but it won't. He tries to paddle it forward, he's into the pocket and eventually takes it over the line for another throw.
So Dennis Banks looks a little sore in the hamstring there, but I'm really quite just didn't sprint after that ball as though he was really 100% fit. Andrews gets the ball down. It's taken this time by Banks. Snaps towards goal. Mullane coming in to take the mark. And Mullane, who kicked the goal just a moment ago, is only 5 metres out directly in front. So Darren Mullane shifts it to the half-forward line. Could have two goals in a matter of minutes. And on replay, we see Banks put the ball forward and Mullane take the mark. So it will be a 32-point margin, and which surely, Sandy, with 20 minutes about to tick around, spells doom for Footscray as Collingwood go to 32 points with a goal by Darren Mullane, his second.
Just on the 20-minute mark, it's all over for Footscray. 14-17 to 9-15. And here it is again in replay, the last look of season 84 for Footscray fans as Banks puts it high in the air. And as Bobby called it, Mullane eyes on the ball, marking in the square in front of Mike Egan. He converts, and Collingwood go on. Footscray say farewell.
Looks like being 14 consecutive losses here for Footscray, Sandy.
This hasn't been a happy hunting ground.
So from the centre bounce, it'll be Purser and Cloak. Cloak grabs it out of the centre. The hand pass runs towards Tony Shaw, who taps it on to Raines. Good play. Raines now puts the long kick up towards the square. Andrews and Williams both up. Neither can take the mark. It's picked up by Anderson of Footscray. He swings it wide out towards Hawkins on the centre wing, or half-back flank actually, and Hawkins out wide takes the mark. Doug Hawkins across the ground with a short pass to McKenna. McKenna, the hand pass over the top, finds Foster. Foster with a beautiful kick, high and long. Beasley from behind, taps it on. Duperuzel couldn't grab it. Beasley does now. The hand pass towards Wallace. Wallace snaps towards goal. He's offline though, and only 1 point the result. So 1 point to Steve Wallace. And the Footscray have only added 3 points in this quarter, whilst Collingwood have kicked 4 goals, 2. McKeon puts the ball back into play. McMullen up, couldn't quite take the mark. Phillips takes it. The hand pass across to Jamie Turner. He couldn't take it. It's kicked off the ground by McPherson. Dummies well. Straightens up and hooks it down towards the goal square. Beasley in position. Couldn't take the mark at the back. And Toomey just allows it to run through for 1 point. And 1 more point to Footscray, and they're 9-17 to 14-17. 5 goals the margin. David Toomey. The lead from David Cloak. Cloak takes the mark. Cloak content to take his time. Give the hand pass, a shocking hand pass, but Toomey gets a favourable bounce. Comes across. He looks for Phillips this time. Groenewagen puts it down. Tony Shaw gets the short one out there to Phillips. Phillips puts the ball wide. Richardson's there. Taps it, should tap it on. Does so well. Good play, Richardson, as it's taken now by Gary Shaw. Shaw towards goal. Gary Shaw. No mistake. Gary Shaw kicks his second, and it's a 36-point lead. 15-17 to 9-17.
Sevens Big League is part of the 1984 Nissan VFL Premiership season.
Less than a kick in it at half-time, 8 points at three-quarter time, but Collingwood going right on with the job in the final term to win by 43 points and consolidate their place in the five. Goal kickers for Collingwood, Gary Shaw and Williams got 3 each, and for Footscray, their main goal kicker was Edwards, and he also finished up with 3. Insofar as the stats were concerned, Collingwood on top in all departments, except the hit-outs at Victoria Park this afternoon.